Sound check. All right, I think we are back. Painful. Hope that doesn't happen again. So, apparently losing two games in a row makes me drop my internet connection. Why didn't I exchange queens? That's my whole brilliant idea. Well, it's gonna take a minute to get back into the groove of things here. Apparently, I like to move faster than I may calculate. Resign this, because there's no consequence to losing three in a row. It means that I'll get a better pairing next time. Yeah. Pretty cool. I'm trying to see like what kind of tricky stuff can I come up with. Unfortunately, I'm falling for half the tricks that exist. I need to improve that rate just a bit. Helps when you can predict your opponent's next move. And there's something you can do about it, which often there's at least something you can do. Ah, so I went on time. You know, Llama Lord, we're gonna get paired eventually. Do recognize this. It's inevitable. The server will pair us. But I'm sure it'll be toward the end of the event when it doesn't matter so much. In the meantime, we're getting all these accelerated pairings. Oh wow. That's gutsy to not take the bishop. Oh, queen there isn't. Oh, wait, I got a mating net. Bam! Holy moly. That's awesome. Okay, well, that's going to be my best game of the tournament. Glad I came back to stream that. Oops. Okay, well, so much for trying to be tricky. That's not a good. I don't know. So, what are we looking at here? I'm gonna do night piece. Control the file. I control this file. Turn of events. For one direction or another. It can win the rook. Guard that square. And then just start taking stuff this way. You don't always have to play the objective best moves to win a game. Hey, welcome, LC. So yeah, I'm just throwing some openings out. Not really sure what's going on. Oops. Unwise. A lot of things that are dubious in normal chess work in bullet, and vice versa. I need to develop my other rook. Knight's quite annoying. Need a square for my knight. Up there, that's indeed it is a fork. Yep, and mate. Oh, that's not mate. Okay. Oops, well, that's a problem. So many games, so much time remains. Okay. It's gonna hurt. I don't know who of us it's gonna hurt, but at least one. I'm not going to do anything stupid there. Wow. Okay. Maybe this guy will fall for something. But maybe not. Funny how, like, every game in the opening I'm hanging a piece. And I keep claiming that maybe the next time my opponent's gonna fall for something. I'm the one who's hanging all the pieces. Just some irony there. Like, I should be more concerned about my own... less concerned about what my opponent's gonna do. This is a pretty extreme event, I agree. I got lucky. Oh, I got lucky. That's how you play Bullet. Keep the pressure coming. Okay. Okay, 18th place. Wow. And everybody else here is like a 2200, so... we're just gonna resign that. There's no coming back from down a bishop. Still 18th place, but there goes my winning streak. Oh, we got a 2000. Okay, I'm not gonna repeat that twice, am I? Oh, wow. Opening novelty is not strong. Yeah. That's what it's about. You gotta take your points where you can get them. Hey, we got the Llama Lord. This should be fun. Gonna kill me. This is extremely stressful, is it not? That was quite a game. That quite a game, quite a show. I completely agree with your analysis. This is like the most stressful tournament ever. Try not to get too attached to the results, because once you start getting attached, it's all over. You had me. Oh, yeah, I guess out of the opening, you totally had me. I was gonna say that middle game, or I'm sorry, that end game did not go so well, but yeah, you definitely had a very, I mean, you had me. Yeah. No dancing around that issue. I said as much, like, I fully expected to lose that just because you tend to clock me in the opening before I can even get anything going. By clock, I mean the classical definition of the word clock, where you just like smash somebody. Okay. Oh, this is strange. Oh, you serious? Hey, well done. Yeah, but 3 second tournaments don't go for 4 hours. That's the thing. That this is going to be a measure of endurance and of internet speed. I can't count. Watch me not count. Look at all that not countingness. I guess I have to take. To play this out. No, he's gonna leave. If I played any, why would I play a 24-hour tournament? Oh my. Okay. Play what we know. And if what we know is kind of rubbish. Oh, kind of a problem. Bummer. Just need to demonstrate more skill in said end games. Why am I getting paired way the hell down? So bizarre to me. Unless that's saying that the rest of the tournament I got paired up way too much. Best game of all time. Knight e2 checkmate. Who doesn't want a piece of that? Okay. Oops, not accurate. Okay. This is so precarious. It's absurd. Ah, he found it. Okay. It would have been so nice to win that too. I got Swamp Dweller again. Wonder when he's gonna get tired of this thing. Actually, why did I not just like resign already? I want a better pairing. I want to win the event. Should be resigning now, or now, or now. How about now? Now's a good time to resign. But no, we're not in it, I guess, for the trophy. We're in it for the glory of trying to play well, and I mean, what greater reward is there? Yeah, the trophy is pretty nice, but I've got to effectively cheat to get it, then it's not worth it. Can't help but notice that my pairings aren't getting any easier. Why am I so bad? I mean, aside from the lack of skill, lack of opening knowledge. There's no winning that down a rook, so in order to try to restart my streak here, I need to just resign that. Here's to dubious openings. Cause of and solution to all of life's problems. That takes. I'm just losing that, so. Because I'm playing somebody my own rating, I'm just gonna resign. I'll just continue repeatedly resigning until I finally get something that I'm able to play. Well, not just play, but win. There's so much of a bonus for winning consecutive games that the only way to make it to the top, well, I mean, you have to either be really good and, like, legitimately win every game, or you have to take some pretty hideous risks. Most of those aren't going to work out for you. Why do tactics not work for me? See the tactic, but what do I do about it? I didn't see the tactic. Tactics on this square. And oh, well, poo. At least you didn't see the more crushing tactic. Okay, I'm down 10 seconds and down forever in materials, so I'm going to resign again. Giving me another 2100 to play. Oh, can't take that. It's like people are watching my stream and choosing their opening based on. Well, they don't have time to do that, but. That would be an incredible conspiracy if it did happen. Hey, I just lost like 5 games in a row. That's what's happening. I'm playing the Lee Chess Experimental Marathon. I'm sure I'm going to lose many more games in a row playing like this. There goes the H pawn, and with it, any hope of redemption there. So, I mean, you don't lose anything for other than points or rating points for losing games. 1, 2. Actually, I suppose that given my tournament standing, it doesn't make any difference how often I resign, because I'm going to get paired against 2100s no matter what. This started an hour and a half ago, and it's going for another 2.5 hours. But yeah, I ought to play things. I ought to invent an opening and call it the coin flip opening. That's what needs to happen here. Because eventually that coin will flip heads, and things will turn in my favor. Check. That's what I'm talking about, is that people will miss things. Oops. Well, we both hung rooks there. Well, you call it the coin flip opening because either it works beautifully for you or it just completely loses the game outright. That's the sort of stuff I need to be playing. If I want to win the tournament, I've got to just play some really ridiculous openings. Like, you think that you've seen everything. You have not. There's more crazy stuff coming. What do I do now? Develop. So that didn't quite work. See, the 0-0-0-0-0-2-0. I'm on a pretty bad losing streak at the moment. And so I pull out of my bag of tricks some openings I've never played before. Oh, he got me. I didn't see that at all. Okay. Well, I mean, you say you're playing terrible. Put it in the context of out of my last 8 games, I've lost 7 of them. And realize that it's just a tough event. Like, terrible in this event would be if you lose every game. Because really, any other result is a good result. It's a ridiculously strong event. And it sure annoys me a lot that I lose so much, but there's just, it's futile. There's nothing I can do about it. Oh, you got me. Yep. Absolutely nothing I can do. That's 8 losses in 9 games. Finally, I get paired with somebody below 2,000. Watch and see if I'm able to do anything. Oh, I get forked. Yep. Most inconvenient. Get the rook out of it. Oh, now I'm getting probably killed on the king side. Good. That's not good. Fortunately, he can't do tactics. I'm going to take him into a rook endgame. Pretty dubious rook endgame at that. Oh, that sucks. There goes my rook. So, I lost to a 2,000. I bet I'm going to lose to a 1,900 next. We'll see. This is true, Laura. Truly, there is no music today. As much as I do enjoy music, I don't know how to stream with music without getting all my highlights muted. So. That's why there's no music, is because I can't run music and still retain the rights to get my stream going later. So if I could figure a way to solve that and get music that I enjoy, I would totally play music on my stream. Sometimes I do stream myself playing music. Okay. I might have a tactic here. There we go. Fortune finally favors me. I'm not going to go like zero out of a million games here. I'm actually going to win one. Truly, this is an achievement. Wait, I'm playing the French against the Llama Lord? Oh my goodness. I don't know which is more unlikely, that we get paired again, or that I'm playing the French. Ah! Okay. I walked into mate in one in that opening, didn't I? What can we do to improve upon this? Not do that again. Gotta stick with this. Okay, we got a big message here, and I can't read it. Oh, yeah, I can see that now. Good old Romeo. I suspect that by now, the Llama Lord's probably passed me in the tournament standings. I mean, given that I won, like, two games in 11 or 12 or something, I'm not going very far on the standings. I guess what that means is that at the start of the tournament, weaker players showed up than showed up during the tournament. Game by game, the opponents that are still in this event are not only the ones who survive and choose to keep continue playing, but are also the players who didn't hear out about the tournament until about halfway through. Okay, so we got Blitzstream again. I always try doing something a little confusing for him. Because I know that we're both going to end up confused, but at least in whatever chaos happens, there's some minute chance that I might be able to swindle something. I lost a knight. I lost a knight and a bishop. Probably going to lose my queen soon. I'm just keeping the trend going. Resign this. There's no reason for me to play on against a 2300. And I could get paired with somebody else. Excellent. Like I was saying, resign against high-rated players, and accept resignations against low-rated players. It's a brilliant scheme. The only problem with it is that sometimes lower players don't resign. They're not in on the whole arrangement. And sometimes they'll actually beat you. Okay. What am I not seeing here? Oh, shit. Yep, and that's pretty much how Bullet goes. Yeah, no, playing this D5 crap makes no sense. But it definitely gets the opponent thinking. Oops. Yeah, I'll resign that. That's the point, is that I can play a 10-move game against a 2300, and then I can play a different game. And I don't care how many times I lose to 2300s unless I'm on a winning streak. What this means for my rating, though, is that my rating's absolutely going in the tank for the way, for this strategy I'm employing. Yeah, I just crossed 2,000, as I predicted. So I was like 2150 or 2130 or something before this. And now because I'm resigning to just like everybody to try to catch my way back up the tournament, yeah, my rating takes a very steep hit for that. But I know I'm not going to beat the 2300, I'm going to beat like the 2000 or the 1800. Now, it's one thing, like, say if a 2300 drops a piece in the opening, which I'm playing very provocatively, so sometimes that happens, but most of the time, yeah, I just end up blundering stuff in the opening. Damn it. My mouse failed me there. Or rather, my hand failed my mouse. But I didn't deserve to win that anyway. Oh. Well, well, well. There we go. Cheapo 1 of 2 fails, Cheapo 2 of 2 succeeds. Yeah, trying to flag the opponent, that's the one thing. If you watch the first hour and a half of the stream, you'll notice that I did try to do that. And the players in this tournament are just too fast for that. They're the kind who will flag you when you're trying to flag them. That's the mentality of the player who's in this particular event. Consequently, they tend to blunder a lot. But as much as they blunder, I blunder even more, so it doesn't put me at any advantage to know that. Oh, I can't do that. I could go back here. Ah! Okay. At least I won. But oh man. Okay, sorry about that. I apologize. So, I was just a little bit stressed there over having messed it up. But fortunately, that didn't matter. Okay, so we're in 24th place, taking a whole ton of beatings. That's like every time I get on a streak, that's when I get paired way up. Okay. Oops. Well, okay, so he gets back the pawn. Okay. All my pieces are misplaced. Typical. This is not good. Seriously, not good. There is my miracle of a reprieve here. The knight interferes with this cannon. Would otherwise crush me down that file. That was close. That was way too close for comfort. And look, YB Matt has joined the tournament and has won a bajillion games in a row. Oh, there he goes up the standings. Okay. So somehow I got paired with YB Matt. Don't ask. This is gonna hurt. Oops, not get mated. I swear, if I win this, it's not happening, but if I do, I don't know. Okay, well, that was. Oh shit, how the hell did I get paired with him again? What the hell? That's. Seriously? Seriously, Leeches, did you have to do that? Was that completely necessary? Is this karmic retribution of some sort? What did I do to deserve this? Oh, Leeches, don't do this to me. That's one thing to get paired against YB Mad. It's another thing to get paired twice in a row against him, especially when the first time you cheapoed him. Oh man. Yeah, I don't know what to do. Got me. Okay. I deserved that. I totally did. Now don't pair me against him a third time in a row. There we go. Oh man. What am I even playing? This chess, is this bullet? What is this? Yeah, I can pre-move this, because if I get checked, pre-move cancels. Never ever relied on that kind of pre-move technique before. Okay. Black is victorious. You gotta know your endgames. Yeah, it's great that the server's doing wonders, but Ornikar, you missed my last few pairings. I got paired with YB Mad after he won like 15 games in a row. And then I beat him on time. So guess who I got paired against? You missed it. You should have seen it, man. It was the most incredible pairing I've ever seen. Yeah, I don't know. Like, his internet connection must have been lagging or something. That's the only possible explanation. I know. As fast as I move, he's like 10 times faster. Oh, he berserked on one of the games. Okay, that's how I ended up so far up on time. Yeah, I just know when I looked over at the clock, there was no way I could make sense of it. Take the rook, let's take the rook. Well, it's not checkmate. That's spectacular, though. I wasn't looking at his clock that second game. Clearly, he was out to prove a point that second game if he berserked against me, which I take it on your word he did, because, I mean, yeah. He must have been quite irate about that. Okay, so there I am dropping everything. Not good. Oops. Kind of gives me an excuse to resign it, too. Again, I have to keep apologizing for the lack of commentary, because there's no time for me to think, let alone commentate. Oops, there goes my queen. Takes it. Not mate. For a second there, I thought I had no legal moves. I'm like, I can't do king here, king here, king here. And I'm like, oh, that one's legal. Let's play it. And I take the rook. Because why would I assume that he'd hang a rook, right? Not everybody's as good at hanging pieces as I am. Actually, queen f5's mate. How many people are in this tournament anyway? Or rather, what's the player count for the tournament? Not how many are currently playing, but if you were to add up everybody who was playing at one point, how many would you count? And for those who have played at least a few moves of a game and actually completed a game. I assume as most of the people who have played in the event, but I mean some people might have played in the event and like not played a single move. I'm just gonna resign that. There's no saving it.